Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Hold My Nugget Studios once again for the fourth and final installment of Divisional Weekend. As the two oldest quarterbacks on planet Earth still running on Icy Hot and Ben Gay look to do battle to advance to the NFC Championship. As the face of Uggs, husband of Giselle, Tom Brady playing football since the FDR administration, national champion at Michigan, six-time Super Bowl championship winner, seeking a 14th visit to the championship Sunday, his first with the NFC. And on the other side, Drew Brees playing football since they put the first nail in the hand of Jesus Brees, taking the football field for what could possibly be his final home game in New Orleans. These two absolute legends in the game occupy the number one and number two slots in nearly every statistical passing category in league history. As Brees and Brady meet for the first time in the postseason and the eighth time in their careers, Brees with the edge being 5-2, with two victories this season coming by blowout to add insult to injury as the first quarterback to lead a season sweep in the division over Tom Brady. But refusing to be denied, the Buccaneers look to rewrite history, walking into the Superdome winners of five straight, with plans to be the team of destiny in the hopes of being the first team in NFL history to host the Super Bowl as it's being played in Tampa Bay. Their first meeting in 2002, and this could be their last meeting in 2021, as the fifth-seeded Tampa Bay Buccaneers travel to the Superdome, brother, to take on the two-seeded New Orleans Saints in your 2020 NFL Playoff Divisional Round Weekend Game! Highlight commentary. And here come the Tampa Bay Kaizoku Buccaneers, baby. Franchise record 30 points per game, while only turning over the football 17 times, the fewest in franchise history, and winning their first playoff game since Super Bowl 37, led by those Gruden grinders, baby. When is he not mad? Here we go. Opening possession. Brady looking left. And going down the field. Me try hardest, me Gronkowski, me want catch football, it out of reach. The Bucks would be forced to punt following a three and out, and back to receive the kick as the New Orleans misses. Deontay Harris,
excuse me bitch,
makes one Buccaneer miss, and just look at those little legs move. His legs resemble those of centipedes. Give me your ankles, punter. He's gonna return it all the way inside the 20. And back the other way come the New Orleans Saints, the first team in the NFC South to finally sweep that division, led by the legs of Alvin Shinsuke Nakamura, leading the NFL with 21 TDs from scrimmage. And tonight they get their juggernaut offense back together for the fourth time this season, as Brees, Kamara, and Thomas would line up all together. But Blue Eyes, right privilege, Swiss Army knife Taysom Hill will not be in this game. Last week he took an arrow to the knee, so we will never get to hear.
That's how a white man runs a football.
Nevertheless, Drew Brees will take the field with his 7-2 playoff record at home. You know, he used to be undefeated and they lost two in a row. It'd be a shame if it happened the third time. Drew Brees' Jesus takes the snap, looking towards his right. He's got Emmanuel.
I've got a concussion.
What happened?
Well, what do you know? Somehow Emmanuel Sanders was able to survive, but there's laundry on the field. Jordan Whitehead turned into Snorlax, used TMO2, and connected with a headbutt. Critical hit. Luckily, this isn't college football, and his name's not James Kalski, because he's not going to be ejected.
Don't you dare touch me!
Get him out of here!
I'll fucking do it again.
I'll make him bleed.
Why Bruce Arians out here looking like a human angry bird? Third and goal, Michael Thomas submits his application to the 10 toes down challenge with a magnificent one hand catch for the Genjitsu! Although he did catch the football and keep his feet in bounds, that knee touched white like the nose of John Mulaney. So the Saints would have to settle for a 23-yard field goal. Will Lutz kicks it through the uprights. It's good. 3-0 lead for the home team.
Wait a minute. You could have saw this video early and ad-free if you became a level 3-6 member on my Patreon. www.patreon.com/chiseledadonis to get access to those perks.
But back the other way comes Tom Brady. following yet another three and out for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. They're going to have to punt it back to that dangerous New Orleans midget at the 33-yard line.
Excuse me.
Hello, friend.
Excuse me, bitch.
God damn, he out there avoiding more men than lesbians, and he's got open field in front of him. Makes one man miss, cuts inside, and he's going into the end zone for the New Orleans Scandrifers!
Come on back, stupid. There's laundry on the field. Illegal block in the back on the receiving team. There will be no touchdown.
I was hoodwinked, bamboozled, flabbergasted.
And your touchdown was
eliminated.
Ain't this some shit?
Now what am I getting?
And you could have did
now
it.
See,
so
how I get it wrong?
Because you never apologize.
Look at this nincompoop blocking somebody in the back when he ain't even need to.
Get that son of a bitch off the field right now. Out. He's fired. Fired!
Little man was out here avoiding Tampa Bay like I used to avoid my pop's ass whippings, all for naught because one nincompoop decided to block somebody in the back. This is like calling an Uber to leave the premiere only to find out your taxi driver's Harvey Weinstein. One way or another, you're gonna get fucked. New Orleans would have to start this drive from inside their own 30-yard line, but Drew Brees don't give a shit. They're moving the chains.
Cut that bitch off!
Damn, I even get to play the music of Alvin Shinsuke Nakamura. What the hell happened? There's laundry on the field. This man, JPP, only got 8 fingers, but he used every one of his toes to try to trip Alvin Shinsuke Nakamura. This man stepped on the gridiron and took the word football way too seriously. Why are you kicking people in their ACLs, goddammit? The penalty would put New Orleans inside Tampa Bay territory, and they'd slowly march down the field. Time to take a trip inside the kitchen, take a look at the chef, because this Jared Cook...
I dropped it.
Must have hands that are just for decoration. What's wrong with him? You would have thought he was a defender, but hey, it's not like you're gonna fuck up again, right? What happened to his hands? New Orleans would settle for a 42-yard field goal. Will Lutz bangs it through the uprights. It's good. 6-0 lead for the home team. I'll kick Kamara. I'll kick Thomas. I'll kick Breeze. I'll kick all of them motherfuckers over there. Everybody in New Orleans gonna feel the
Falcon kick.
Ensuing drive, Tampa Bay finally moves the chains as Leonard 1-2-3-4 net carries it to the 49. And on the very next play, Brady's going for it all, following two play action fakes. He's got Mike Evans.
Not on my watch.
What does Marshawn Lattimore have against Mike Evans? Every time they play each other, homie put the clamps on him. Mike Evans is the first receiver in NFL history to have 7 straight seasons over 1,000 yards. And he has none of that production against Marshawn Lattimore. 2 plays later, 3rd and 5. Brady finds Chris Godwin. He's going to carry it inside the 35. And as we go into the second quarter, Tampa Bay would send out Ryan, whose mother performed fellatio and sucked an upcurved penis, as he'd line up for a 26-yard field goal, kicks it through the upright, and cuts the deficit in half. Known for his charitable works in New Orleans, look like Drew Brees continues to give back because he's got a man.
Wahoo.
But he plays for the other team. Pass intercepted by Sean Murphy Bunting, and he's headed to McDonald's. Can I get a Mc...
I guess not.
As he'd step out of bounds at the 3. The beautiful thing about NFL football, you can make contact with the receiver all day inside 5 yards. But this right here, that's defensive holding. Holding on to that man waist like they're trying to take a prom picture. And he clamped down on Michael Thomas' face mask. But what I don't understand is how the hell he ain't score a pick 6. You got 2 blockers out in front. All you gotta do is make this fat man miss. To make matters worse, this nincompoop stepped out of bounds early. Like, what is wrong with you? Do you not want to score? Nevertheless, now in the period colored zone, Brady, he's got Mike Evans in the end zone. Touchdown, Bucks. They take the lead. And you know Mike Evans gotta be hyped because this is his first catch against Marshawn Lattimore all year. And he worked them too, straight off the line. You thought I was going outside, you stupid motherfucker, you. Ensuing drive. Why is Drew Brees leaving the field? Taysom Hill's not playing. Wait a minute. It's Jameis Winston in the postseason for the first time in his career. And they're dialing up a little bit of trickery. Direct snap to Alvin Shinsuke Nakamura. Gives it to Emmanuel Sanders. Jameis Winston down the middle. He's got Traquan Smith. Goes into the end zone. Touchdown. Saints, they regain the lead. And that's Sean Payton. Is one delightfully devilish, sneaky son of a bitch. How you gonna take a play that Chicago used against you last week that Javon Mims bum ass couldn't catch and just input it today for Jameis Winston's first postseason pass of his career? And they executed it to perfection. Not only did they score on Tampa, they just slapped their appendage all over the face of Matt Nagy and the Chicago Bears. Once again, redemption and vengeance for Jameis Winston, scoring on his former ball club. And And Drew Brees is loving every second of it.
Oh, fucking do it again. Okay.
Just look at the power of the dreadlocks. Four motherfucking Buccaneers left with Alvin Kamara. Nobody stayed with Traquan Smith. Ensuing drive, third and one. Brady takes the snap. He's going deep and he's got a man. But he plays for the other team. Pass intercepted by Minnesota savior Marcus Williams for the game. This man's football IQ goes out the window when they get to the postseason. How you don't get your right foot down? The momentum's already going downwards. Even Tom Brady is blown away by that man's stupidity. I can't believe he didn't intercept that pass. To make matters worse, they go over sideline interceptions during practice. Clearly, this man was never paying attention.
You big dummy.
Following a Buccaneers punt, here come the Saints. Alvin Shinsuke Nakamura would try to tightrope down the sideline. Following the Saints punt, here come the Bucks. Brady dumps it off to Leonard 1-2-3-4 net, and he carries it into New Orleans territory. And it's time for Brady to find those reliable hands. He's got Chris Godwin for...
I dropped it.
Chris Godwin really made his postseason debut and went out there and dropped all of the footballs. This is ridiculous.
What happened to his hands?
Did Fournette hop in a time machine? This man must think he on the Jags in 2017. Oh no, Tommy Boy dropped his ball. Looking towards his right, he's got his man. It's the clown, Antonio Brown.
Enough from the clown.
And two plays later, looks like Brady's going for it all, looking towards the end zone. He's got his man, Chris Godwin, for the...
I dropped it.
Heavens to Betsy, are we sure this man's hands weren't meant to be feet at birth? This man drops passes every single drive. How you can't catch this? Survive the ground, stupid! When he dies, he's gonna be reincarnated as homeless man's underwear because he clearly can't hold balls.
I lost my orgasm. When I RSVP to a party, I make it my business to come.
Well, guess what, Tommy boy? Looks like Chris Godwin's making sure there will be no ejaculate in the form of a touchdown. So the Bucks would have to settle for a 37-yard Ryan. Why does he only have two siblings? Because his mother sucked up the rest for a 37-yard field goal, kicks it through the uprights, and it's good. Tie game going into the break.
My leg!
What is this? It appears there may be an injury to the clown, Antonio Brown.
Enough from the clown.
Wait a minute. We did it. We did it. We have surpassed the 10K follower mark threshold on the Hot Mic app. So what does that mean? It is confirmed. The giveaway has been completed. We're announcing the winner on Super Bowl Sunday. And now I won't have to scam the people. I can't scam you. Initially, if we stayed at 9,999 people, I would have probably held on to the console myself. But then somebody had to go and make it the 10,000. So now that we're past 10,000, I gotta give these son of bitches away. I'm never gonna get an opportunity to play you. At least these two in particular. I will have to probably buy another one for myself. But damn it, giving them away Super Bowl Sunday. If you haven't already entered, you missed out, goddammit. You missed out.
Damn, Michael Thomas really out here just doing cardio. Into the second half we go. Alvin Shinsuke Nakamura takes the football inside Buccaneers territory. And it appears that the hitmen hired by Green Bay still haven't done their job because Ty Montgomery is still alive. The Saints in the Barun colored zone, Rosetta Stone, Sundanese, motherfucker. As Drew Brees' Jesus got Traquan Smith in the end zone participating in the 10 toes down challenge. Back shoulder fade, touchdown! Saints, they regain the lead. Whispered in his ear, hold my nuggets. Suck my dick! Ensuing drive, time for Tom Brady to give back to the community. Got a man! But he plays for the other team for the New Orleans Gadgets! If that was ruled a catch, Michael Jackson's pronouns might as well be he. Back the other way we go. Drew Brees' Jesus play action fake showcasing his charitable works. The passes!
Oh, I missed!
Antoine Winfield Jr., clearly not as good as his father. How you drop that? What is good with these offsprings of Pro Bowl corners unable to catch interceptions? First in the national championship, Patrick Surtain II couldn't catch a pick. And now in the NFL playoffs, Antoine Winfield Jr. can't catch a pick. I don't care how old my child is. If you drop a pick after I was a legend in the league, when I see you in the locker room...
Biatch! Stupid bitch!
Fuck them kids.
Third and two, Brees looking to go into Buccaneers territory. He's got a Jared who cooks, but he cooked up some butter fingers. Fumbles on the play, it's recovered by Devin White and returned inside New Orleans territory.
Falcone!
punch!
All right, Antoine Winfield Jr., I take it back. Maybe you don't deserve to be punched in the locker room. Today we learned he can't catch a football, but he can punch one. I wonder what Jared Cook is thinking as he's falling, knowing he's not going to recover this football.
Stand back!
Ensuing drive following the turnover, play action fake, Brady looking towards his right. Eh? He's got the most educated man on the field, graduate of Harvard University, Cameron Brait, to the 20. And it looks like they finally got enough VC to unlock Ronald Jones. Where the hell he been the whole game? Now in the swoop zone, Brady dumps it off. Eh? He's got Leonard Fournette. He goes into the end zone. Touchdown, tie game. I don't know why Leonard Fournette over here talking shit to his teammates like, yeah, yeah, when this man nearly dropped the damn football. This entire postseason, across the entire NFL, every single running back been bobbling footballs, bruh.
You brought shame upon yourself and your family.
How could this happen to me? I made my mistakes. Got nowhere. The night goes on as I'm fading away.
Damn, damn, damn.
Following the score, ensuing drive, New Orleans trying to stop the momentum.
I guess not.
Ensuing drive, fresh off of being unlocked, into the fourth quarter we go. Ronald Jones gets the handoff. He's going to carry it into New Orleans territory on a 45-yard. Get that sack!
Hold in on the offense. That shit's coming back.
This fat motherfucker tried to tickle his goddamn Adam's apple. What's wrong with him? Third and 11, Brady looking right. Eh? He's got Tyler Johnson with a magnificent catch to move the chains. Women with the top subscribers on OnlyFans couldn't even catch balls like that. Three plays later, Brady's looking too cool. Eh? Because he's got Scotty Too Hotty Miller inside New Orleans territory. There was a dead body found in Janoris Jenkins' house. It looks like on the field, Scotty Miller may have killed him. And it looks like Tampa Bay will continue to unleash the fresh legs.
Hello, Dwight.
Spin move.
And Ronald Jones takes it inside the 20. And once again, Brady's going for it all, looking for his BFF. Eh? He's got Gronk in the... Me, Gronkowski, I try catch touchdown again for you, Tom, but once again, it's out of reach. Third and 9, Brady must be at an Afro Fest, because he's throwing pick.
I dropped it.
Ain't nobody on this field got hands, bruh. How do you drop this interception? Does nobody want to win this game? Hey, Ryan, why does your mom only like to do fellatio while laying on her back? Because she likes to suck up. As he connects on a 36-yard field goal and Tampa Bay regains the lead. Hey, Drew, it's your last game. Why not build some new memories? I agree, says Devin White. As the pass is intercepted by the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, he nearly throws the dreadlock straight off of a Saints wide receiver and returns it to the 18-yard line.
Some old bullshit.
So you mean to tell me Drew Brees been playing football for 20 years and he just gonna throw hot routes without telling his receivers? That gotta be the easiest interception Devin White ever caught in his entire life. Drew must be playing on rookie mode. Helen Keller, Stevie Wonder, and Ray Charles could have caught that interception. Hey Drew, that's only 2 interceptions, 3 turnovers. Not like you're gonna turn it over again, right? Tom Brady would once again get an orgasm as he'd go into the end zone and give the Bucs a 10-point lead.
Oh, shit.
High five.
Tom, don't make it so obvious.
Let's review how we got to this point. Brees throws his first interception of the day. That leads to a Mike Evans touchdown. Then Jared Cook can't hold on to the football. That leads to a Leonard Fournette touchdown over the middle. All of a sudden, Drew Brees wants to throw another apple turnovers. That leads to Tom Brady getting into the end zone. Moral of this story? The New Orleans Saints are the Pittsburgh Steelers of the NFC.
Hey, I hope you're enjoying the video thus far, but make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. But more importantly, follow me on all social media networks, whether that's YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Pornhub, TikTok, doesn't matter. Follow me on all platforms, because they continue to block me. Back to your regular scheduled program.
So just do it!
You're the Super Bowl 44 MVP. You're the all-time leader in pass yards and completions. You're a 13-time Pro Bowl selection. This is going to be your last game in New Orleans, and this the performance that you put on? I mean, it's not the first time that an all-time great ended up having their last game be an absolute catastrophe. Dan Marino went out completely fucked up. But hey, you still got a little under 5 minutes left. You still got some magic in that right arm to make...
Game over.
Some more apple turnovers, pass intercepted again. Drew Brees! You came out here in what could be the final postseason game of your career, your final game at home in the house that you built, only to throw three interceptions and turn the football over a total four times? After a decade of absolute playoff debacles, you thought this year would be different. The football gods and the most Tom of Brady said, not today. Nothing but pain and misery in your future. Get off the field for the final time, old man, and put your motherfucking head back down.
But pick it back up, because you had a hell of a career, man.
This motherfucker, Jared Cook, try to catch a football with his bicep.
Damn, even his son can't bear to watch the final moments. He gotta leave the skybox. A little over 4 minutes left to play. The Saints desperately need a stop. They're not going to get it. Chris Godwin found his hands inside Saints territory. Out of timeouts, a first down puts this game away, and the Buccaneers are on to the NFC Championship. The Saints lose in the postseason again.
Don't have to say what you did.
I already know. There's just no chance.
You and me. Don't it make you sad enough?
And with that final kneel down, the illustrious 20-year career of Drew Brees appears to be over as the Tampa Bay Buccaneers take down the New Orleans Saints, hand them their third consecutive home loss in the postseason after starting a perfect 7-0, and they're on to the NFC Championship.
Hey, hello, can I speak to Bill?
This is Bill talking.
It's me, Tom. How does it feel to be home on Championship Sunday, bitch?
Son of a bitch. Hey, that's exactly what he is.
As the New Orleans Saints would head to Elimination Station and take out their Metro cards and to get aboard the L train. But their ride would be short-lived because they go somewhere different. For their failures of capitalizing on playing at home for the third consecutive season. Their failures of advancing back to the NFC Championship. Their failures of giving Drew Brees the proper send-off he truly deserves. Consider your names written down the death note, because your dreams of making it back to the Super Bowl, your dreams of hoisting up one more Lombardi, your dreams of making Brees not get embarrassed on national television has been absolutely deleted.
A great opportunity squandered? Absolutely. A crushing blow? Yes. Will I get over it? No. But life goes on. Not for me.
One thing left to do. Gotta write their names in the death note.
Delete!
Delete, delete, delete.
Delete. Delete, delete, delete.
Delete.
delete, delete, delete.
Delete, delete, delete.
Deletion.
Deletion.
Hawkeye.
You will rest in peace.
Sunday, but you missed out. You missed out. You missed out.